So good evening everyone. Today we are talking about introgression, you know. By looking at the name, it just sounds a little bit more complicated it has to be, isn't it? So it's introgression is actually come from three different words, okay? So the first two come from Latin. Into, I think it's a fairly straightforward one. It's actually to the inside of something. So it's a transfer of something into something. And gravity is actually come from the word walking. So these are like something walking into something. And lastly, we have egression. Egression actually come from English, means ingression, means integration of something into something else. So if you combine the whole thing and actually try to define introgression, so introgression is actually the transfer of genetic information. It doesn't have to be a single gene, it can be multiple thread from one species. To another. So basically just you want to transfer one gene from one species of the plant to be specific into another species, as a result of hybridization. So you're creating hybrids. So in the mean, while you're creating hybrids, you're introducing one gene from one place into another. So that is what introgression means. The transfer of genetic material from one species into another species through hybridization technique. Of course, because this is actually done pre-genetic information. The word actually started from the mid-17th century. So this is about the same time where we discovered, you know, the methyl, the person that tried to, you know, combine peas and try to sort out some genetic information. Mendel, yeah, the Mendel person. It is around the same time where they actually discovered the whole thing and they try to invent this word. But the actual introgression is very popularized among the 1950s, where a lot of plant hybridization research starts to performing. Of course, there's two words you need to take note here. So the first one is hybridization. Because what is the meaning of hybrid? That's the first thing you need to know. So in the basic biological species concept, a hybrid, or we call natural hybrid, is a product of interbreeding. Okay, so you're breeding among the two species. So the reason you call inter. So two different species, you breed them individual from two distinct population. Okay, or groups of populations. So you're trying to put like a Western pea and a Eastern pea together. You're trying to interbreed them so that then the product, which is the offspring, we call them a hybrid, because we will never know which is a species or another until very, very much later, where the concept of the biological species concept come in. So since we are talking about hybrid, we also just take some time to define what is a species. A species is a group of individual, they are capable of producing a fertile offspring. Okay, I think I said this many times in my video already. So if a lion and tiger mate, they can actually produce something called liger or tigon, but that is not called the tiger and lion are not called one species, because ligon or tiger, they are infertile, means that they are not able to produce offspring. So species are two animal that when they mate, they produce a fertile offspring. Like you have a African American, you have another crustacean, or you have an Asian, you have American, you know, with any human on the earth, when they interbreed, they produce a fertile offspring. That's why we call all human a single species. But that is a little bit more complicated in plants, because plants is a lot more flexible compared to animal. A lot of plants, even though they are distinctly different in terms of trait, in terms of genetic composition, in terms of chromosome number sometimes, when they interbreed, they produce a fertile offspring. So it happens a little bit in animal as well. So they're a lot more flexible. That's why introgression here, we call it a subjective term. Introgression, so it's actually a subjective term, because in certain time, the hybrid that we produce are not actually from different species. Let's say in the initial idea where we want to produce a pug, you know, the flat face, horrible looking dog, which is incredibly cute. That's something really funny about human being. So we are actually breeding the gene into the offspring. I'm going to show you how later, but it's not technically from a different species. So you can just call it natural breeding, but in certain definition, you can call it introgression, because you're trying to take that kind of flat face, you know, horrible face forming, collapsing gene into the population of pug. So you become a specific breed. Okay, so this is actually what we call species boundary. So now I'm just gonna just roughly walk you through how you can introduce a gene from a different species into the species. Okay, let's say you have a red plant here. I'm just gonna draw a human because it's a lot easier for me to understand. And let's say you have another one, which is, let's put it black color. Okay, so these are two distinct different species. Let's say you have two tomatoes. So one tomato is black, one tomato is red. Okay, so you want to produce a tomato which is red, but it's with a little bit of black inside them, so that maybe one side is black, everything else is red. So you have a tomato that is mostly red, but have a little bit of black on the side. Okay, so just make it easy. Usually it's like a drought resistant, salt resistant or whatever, but just make it into a physical trait that we can observe, so it's a lot easier. So now you have a red tomato, you have a black tomato. So their species is slightly different. They're not exactly the same species, but they can interbreed and produce a fertile offspring. Okay, in that sense. So now you produce a species. So usually an offspring will get about 50% gene from one parent and another 50% from another parent. Okay, so you got an offspring that looks somewhat like this. Make sense? So half from the parents, from the black parents, half from the red parents. Okay, so what you do is that what we always do with dogs, you take the offspring and you mate again with the parents. Okay, so these two mated, and you know, so they each got 50% from each parent. So now everything mostly is, so you got 50% of this and you only got 50% of this. Okay, so you see, so the traits come from here. You got 50%, 50 into what we call 75%, 25, something like that, composition. Okay, so you got diluted down. Then what we do, we do the same cross again. Then you cross it again with a red tomato once more. Okay, so this is actually the F1. This is the F1, this is the F2, and now we're going to produce the F3. Okay, so we produce the F3, which is everything else is red, but you have a little bit of black. Okay, in that sense, you have 12.5% black here, 12.5% black, and you have 87.5% red. Okay, let's say, so if you are happy with this, then you are successful. The introgression works. You have introduced 12% of the gene into the offspring that you want. So this is one of the introgression line that you can have. So introgression line is just kind of a subspecies territory already, because you are creating kind of a new species, but it's a bit smaller. So we call this a subspecies. Okay, so this is also called introgression line. So let's say you are not satisfied again. You want a little bit more red. then what you can do, you cross it again, then you produce what we call F4 offspring, okay? I'm not sure people do it that much, but never mind, let's just throw it in theory anyway. Okay, so you mate with another parents, and you get, again, by half. So you only get a little bit of the black feet over here. So, and you half 12.5 again, which I actually don't know how to calculate, so we just put it 6.25, okay? So 6.25 of the black color of the black gene, and you have 93.75% rate, okay? So you see from the chart we checked from the beginning, so you have mostly tomato gene, but you have just a little bit of black color gene introduced into your plant. So in this sense, a practical usage of this will be something like what we say just now, where you have a normal plant, but they're not salt resistant. They are not pest resistant. So you breed it with a wild tomato, which is in a different species, but they are also called tomato for certain reason. And then when they interbreed, the first generation would not produce a very nice tomato. So the fruit's very small, not very juicy. You're not going to sell it. But the second generation, then you start to get a bigger fruit. And it's not as big as the original one, but it's adequate enough. So what do you interbreed them again, then you get 12.5%, then you get 6.25%. So if you do this many times, and you always choose the one with the best trait, so in this case that will be the biggest tomato and also salt resistant at the same time. So of course you're not gonna do it once and get your parents and get the offspring product that you want. You have to do it like 20 times, 30 times. You get hundreds of different offspring and you choose from one. And then you take that one, you get another parents, breed again, you get 100, you choose another one, you get a parents, and you breed again. So in random chances, you get something like this, where you get mostly just tomato, and you get a little bit of stress resistant. Okay, so you have, in this case, you have introgress. I don't think there's a verb for this. So you have introduced a stress resistant gene into this tomato plant. In this case, this is the overall process of introgression. So of course it can be done a lot easier with genetic modification, but this is the method where we do without genetic modification technique. Okay, so just a short summary again. So introgression actually come from the mid 17th century, where intro and grady come from the Latin word. Intro means you into something else, and grady means walk, means you actually step into something. Okay, so you have one gene, that gene actually step into the bigger plant, so you're introducing gene into something else. So egression here actually come from ingression from English, where it actually means just migrate in. So you're migrating one gene into a new parent. So what we actually do here is that if you have two different species over here, so in plants, of course, it's not as strict as, you know, animal. Sometimes when two different species breed, they actually can produce a fertile offspring to a certain extent if they're not that different from one another. So in this case, you produce F1 offspring, and you are not happy with it, you produce F2 offspring. So eventually, when you do this enough number of time with enough random chances, you end up with one introgression line where you have just the correct amount of 6.25 within the tomato, so you can produce a very good tomato, and at the same time it is actually resistant to whatever trait that you want. So that's basically introgression. Thanks for watching, see you in the next one.